Out of all the evidence used to support the theory of evolution, what would you say is the strongest, most irrefutable single piece of evidence in support of the theory?
There's an enormous amount of evidence from all sorts of places, and it's hard to pick one strand which is more important than any other. There's fossils, there's the evidence from geographical distribution, there's the evidence from vestigial organs. I think, to me, perhaps the most compelling evidence is comparative evidence from modern animals, particularly biochemical comparative evidence, genetic, molecular evidence. If you take any set of animals and identify the same gene in different animals, and you really can do that because the letters of the DNA code, that's the same code in all animals, and you really can find a gene which is the same in, say, all mammals. For example, there's a gene called FOXP2, which is a couple of thousand letters long, and most of the letters are the same in any mammal, so you know it's the same gene. And then you go through and you literally count the number of genes, of a number of letters that are different. So in the case of FOXP2, if you count the number of letters that are different between humans and chimpanzees, it's only about 9. So in the case of FOXP2, if you count the number of letters that are different between humans and chimpanzees, it's only about 9. If you count the number of letters that are different in humans and mice, it's, I don't know, 30 or something like that. But actually, frogs have them as well, and you find a couple of hundred that are different. So you can take any pair of animals you like, kangaroo and lion, horse and cat, human and rat, any pair of animals you like, and count the number of differences in the letters of a particular gene, and you plot it out, and you find that it forms a perfect branching hierarchy. It's a tree, and what else could that tree be but a family tree? And then you do the same thing for another gene. Having got the family tree for FOXP2, you then do the same thing for another gene, and another, and another. You get the same family tree. You also get the same family tree if you take genes that are no longer functional, that are just vestigial, they're not doing anything. It's like fragments of a document on your hard disk which are no longer being used. They're no longer on the directory, so you no longer see them. Again, you get the same family tree. This is overwhelmingly strong evidence. The only way you could get out of saying that that proves that evolution is true is by saying that the intelligent designer, God, deliberately set out to lie to us, deliberately set out to deceive us.